A buzzer took a monkey for a ride in the air. The monkey thought that everything was on the square. The buzzer tried to throw the monkey off of his back, but the monkey grabbed his neck and said, "Now listen, Jack. Straighten up and fly right. Straighten up and fly right. Straighten up and fly right. Cool down, Papa, don't you blow your top. Ain't no use in diving. What's the use of jiving? Straighten up and fly right. Cool down, Papa, don't you blow your top."
It all started with Elio España. He's a world famous tattoo artist. He's known for being in the hardcore scene back in the 80s. And he was friends with Vinnie Stigma and Roger Moret and all the AF guys. And he started tattooing out of Vinnie's apartment. It was awesome. And then he's known for tattooing the big chest piece on Roger, the one he's really known for. The thing about Elio, he knows how to tattoo in any style, anything. And they're clean, it's perfect, solid. You know, that's what kind of made him like a household name. He was basically bouncing around off the Navy 1993 to 96, but then he was in San Francisco. But then he moved to New York and worked at a bunch of shops, most notably Eastside Ink. And then he decided to open his own shop in Williamsburg, Brooklyn, called it Flyrite Tattoo. It was named it after the Nat King Cole song. You know, straighten up and fly right.
Straighten up and fly right. Straighten up and stay right. Straighten up and fly right. Cool down, Papa, don't you blow your top. Fly right.
I was always doing art. I went to school visual arts. I was majoring in cartooning, illustration. I wanted to do comic books. But at the same time, all my group of friends that I was hanging out with were getting tattooed. And I was getting tattooed, meeting people. My main influence was Chris Garver, and a huge impact in my life. And he was really hungry, I was really hungry. I picked his brain about a million things. But I actually got a chance to design my friend's band, Demise. So I did a t-shirt for those guys, and it opened up a whole new world for actually illustrating for like t-shirts for bands and stuff. Set it on. I heard that Elio was looking for a guy to fill a chair, you know, one day a week or something. So I was like, you know, I'm all nervous. I'm like, well, here's my book, check it out. I don't know, maybe I could do a day for appointments. Cause it's like a big deal to kind of walk into a shop and just start doing walk-ins. You know, you don't want to take work away from people that work here. You know, that's just rude, you know? So I actually got my foot in the door, and I got to work Fridays at Flyrite. This was back in 99. You know, as time goes by, you know, you kind of work your way out of neighborhoods or things happen, bills, you know, life happens. So there was an opportunity where I could work more days at Flyrite and actually make a footprint there. You know, it was a big deal, but at the same time, you just go there to work, you know. Also, Flyrite had amazing guest artists come through. And it was really cool to meet everybody that came in. A shop environment is awesome because you get to feed off each other. Like, if you have a problem with a design or a composition, the dude's right there, you know? Let me ask you your opinion. Everybody respects each other because, you know, we're all here for the same reason, to do great work. And somebody, you know, other people have different takes on how a piece should look or what's correct in certain things, so it's really important. It helps you grow as a person. Also, at the end of the day, you're working with people, you know, and you're not working by yourself, you know. You kind of have to, because no one knows everything. was kind of done with the city. I mean, he loves the quiet, he loved the trees, he loved, you know, clean air. And he decided to be like, you know, I wanna buy some property, be an adult, and like, you know, have his own place, something he can own, you know? I had seniority here since I was in 99, but 2010 came, and I decided to be like, all right, I can take over. I guess the crew here as well were like, okay, you're responsible enough to kind of change gears and be the boss, I guess, you know? I always hated that word, but I was confident enough in the talent here and the people that worked here and the trust that we all had together. So I was like, okay, I'll take the next step, because you never know. From the time that I've been proprietor, you know, we've always had a really good crew, I think. There's a lot of people that kind of work through here, that's come through here. Anybody that wants a job here, they've already paid their dues, so they're already established. Mike Lucena from San Francisco, he's been here for a long time now. We have Fernando Lyons, New Yorker. His traditional sense is amazing. We have Jill Gold, you know, and she's versatile pretty much everything. It's a good crew. There's a lot of other shops that have like a million people kind of working, and it's great, but to have a core group that you kind of, basically comes down to like family, you know, and we can kind of rely on each other, keeping the shop, you know, alive and keep the name as strong as it is. We're all always open to guest artists from around the world. You know, we have great friends, and a lot of them love to come here because we have a really good environment, not just for creativity, but we also, you know, feed off each other, and it's a good time. There's nothing shady here, you know? It's awesome. I can be confident and that to have someone here and everyone still like work well with. I'm still inspired by the people that I work with. You can only want to get better. If you're not happy anymore, then why do it, you know? There's still people who come to you to do tattoos on them. You know, that kind of makes me feel like I have a purpose here. You know, I want to keep doing it. Love it.
Straighten up and fly right. Straighten up and stay right. Straighten up and fly right. Cool down, Papa, don't you blow your top. Fly right.